Welcome back, and here is a kit for a full build that I know many of you are waiting on. You've seen me build up MPCs via round two models, 1968 Coronet convertible. Now we've got the hardtop. Newly retooled, everything in the box has been retooled so we can start building these kits again. It's got not only this sweet 68 Coronet with a gajillion option parts in it, it's also got an entire trailer. Just like the Coronet convertible. Comes in an extra big box, a little bit bigger than your standard box, with all vintage style artwork on the side. We got the 440 engine, we've got the trailer, headers, a towing hitch, a jack, custom seats, wheels and tires for the trailer, toolboxes, all kinds of things that aren't even shown on the box, all kinds of goodies. So let's start taking a look at everything that will be in the box when you get yours. First up will be some of the accessory parts. We've got our jacks, our jack stands, we've got our wrench, we've got our towing mirrors. You know, in the old days, they would slap those towing mirrors on a standard family car. Sometimes, without bolting them on, they just strap them on. We've got some red clear plastic, and what is this in this kit? Yes, it is police lights. You can build a squad car, pretty much a pursuit vehicle, from this kit. We've got some clear lenses here. We've got a clear hood scoop. Windshield. Looks like to be the same one that is off the convertible. I like all the mounting tabs and the holes. We've got our headlights. We've got back glass, which we did not have in the convertible version. Large tabs and mounting holes on that. So they've gone through, redone all the tooling. We've got one steel axle, chromed up. We've got a big chrome parts trees. Gorgeous custom wheels, molded open. You can see my flesh behind it. Numerous grills. We got center console and grill options. Love the RT grill with the headlights open. Stock wheels, bumpers, injector. Side mirrors, shifter, we got the big headers. We've got velocity stacks for the injector. Now, I am missing one and it wasn't in the bag, so it must have somehow disappeared. But luckily, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, they give you one extra of the P10 injectors, so I should be okay. Got the lovely chrome headers here. We've got the collectors for the headers right there. We've got our police parts. We've got our antenna, loudspeaker, internals for the wigwags, the light bar itself, and the mounts for the wigwag lights. Great looking chrome tree on that. Check out this decal sheet. Oh, love the Dodge Fever logos. Box art logos, Gonnell's Performance Incorporated, 375, which would be a 440. They got 440 logos. We've got all the Fire Chief logos. We've got our dash decals and yellow and black. We've got RT emblems on there, MPCs, drag logos, super stock. We got haulets instead of U-Haul for the trailer. We've got tail stripes in black, white, red, and yellow gold. Excellent, excellent. In here in white, it says Dodge before the RT, that right there. So you can duplicate that on your body. Awesome, awesome waterslide decal sheet. We will even, since this is new tooling, with some options, we'll take a look at the instruction manual. There's our box art, stock, drag, and trailer, and don't forget the squad car. We've got the buildup for our 440. You can go stock or fuel injected with the headers coming off. I like that they show you a final product on that. And then we do our basic wheel and tire, chassis, interior, getting our frame and everything bolted up. Got our custom or stock. Tells you how to do the stock car or the police car parts, or leave it stock and just don't put the police car parts on it. Tells you how to do the drag version with that clear hood scoop or covered scoop. Now on the back is all the accessories, the trailer, the toolbox, the gas tanks, all the fun stuff on there, and then a full decal guide at the very end. So now we'll switch sides. We'll take a look at the styrene. First up will be the trailer with those high arch springs. We got our jack components here, fuel tank, toolbox, wheel backs for the trailer, awesome diamond plate trailer. I used a trailer like this to haul my newest motorcycle home. Rented it from U-Haul. Definitely way cheaper than buying a motorcycle trailer. Got the sides and the tailgate to the trailer. You can see the little latches. Got the large low profile jack. Got the hitch for the car. Neat little assembly there. And yes, it was extremely common to have a performance car with a hitch on it and use it to tow everything, because those things had awesome strength and power. Got our interior tub here. Molded in. You can see all the location marks for our door panels, our seats, our console, our rear seat. Everything looks great on there. And it's got some holes that you can open up to install the roll cage. So if you want to drill those open, you are welcome to do so on your build. We've got our large chassis here. It's going to be big on this car, obviously. Beautiful firewall, extremely crisp molding. Got our torsion bars, our K-member, our unibody, fuel tank. Really nice engraving on that chassis. A little bit of dry brushing brings that out every time. On this one here, wheel backs, seat backs, stock steering wheel, roll cage components, which have locating holes for everything. I love that. Stock seats, custom seats. I think the stock seats are way better looking, and they have seat belts molded into them. Dashboard looks beautiful. Mopar dashes were pretty plain for the muscle car area, more utility than look. On this tree here, we've got our lovely stock hood. You saw this hood in the convertible build, I'm pretty sure, because I chromed those out. Drag racing hood, which is cut out already for you. Here we've got our air scoop for the drag racing hood if you choose to open these holes and attach that. We've got various body panels, differential, springs, and drive shaft are one piece, individual exhaust, suspension, radiator mount, lots of stuff in this kit. Door panels, nice and crisp, got all the little lines molded into them. Rear seat with seat belts again. Our nice 440 all on its own tree. Stock intake, whoop, just push that free. Cylinder heads, engine and block. Water pump, valve covers, stock manifolds, air cleaner, alternator, fan, belt and pulley looking good. A little bit of flash on the belt and pulley. We can scrape that off with these amazing tools that we have for modeling. It'll take 2 seconds to rub that right off. Then we've got our, looks like our header mounts, wheel pins, exhaust. There's our distributor hiding. And finally, that Coronet hardtop. Isn't that a beauty? Now, there's no trim in here as if it was a vinyl top. If you want to, you can always add that and create your own vinyl top. Or you could mask off the top and paint it even though it's not vinyl. A lot of people did a two-tone. Do what you want on your model. Nice RT emblems molded in. Door panels, ducts there, imitation ducts. Got our rear, all the way around, even got our little marker there. Excellent looking body, just like the convertible, top notch. So I'm going to start gluing this bad boy up, and we will come back to that. There was so much stuff in that box that I actually left some stuff off to the side. So let's take a look. We've got a massive set of tires in this box. We've got some basic bias ply trailer tires. They are no name. There's no brand name on them. They are nice looking. They are a semi-hollow tire, and those will sand down nicely and look lovely underneath the trailer. We've got a sweet, sweet set of pad printed Firestone Drag 500s. No name on the other side if you're not a Firestone fan. Sand these down. They are a solid tire and they will fit over the wheels, those custom wheels. Excellent. and of course red stripes like the convertible. No brand name stamped in, black sidewall and red stripe with a bias ply pattern. These would have been stock on the car. We're going to go with the drags and the trailer tires on there. Nice assortment of tires. They got the best tires in the business over there at Round 2. So now I can finally start gluing mine together that you've seen all the parts in this kit, and I'll see you there. Thank you. Now, obviously, if you see the thumbnail for this video, the day that it comes out, you're gonna know what version of the car I went with. But as I'm building it, I didn't even know yet until I started working on things. So as you can see, I've decided to go with the box art style drag racer. Now, I'm not gonna do an exact copy of the box art. It'll be close, but it will be my version of the car. We've got that 440 built up. I left the valve covers off. I attached the mounts for the headers. I like those mounts on there. We'll see in a moment. I attached this. I want to hand paint it a different color than chrome anyways. So I super glued it in place. Got the cylinder heads on, got the distributor on, and then we just glued everything else together. The valve covers, I'm going to chrome with some chrome spray, and then I will attach them. That's just the way I decided to go with my rig. We got our floor jack. We've got the belt and pulley system with alternator on the back. The toolbox, the fuel can, all that stuff we can throw in the trailer. The headers go together very nicely. And don't cut these off. These are actually the mounts to go inside these holes when you're all done. Now, for my experimentation, I will have to drill out these holes once the engine block is painted. It's not a perfect fit. It might have been if I did it, if I attach this to the headers, but I wanted things a little different on my build, so I'll just have to drill out those center holes all the way through. They're open on the block, but I'll reopen them back up just to make sure that we get a good fit. Also, it says if you're going to use the headers, you should remove the torsion bars. So I remove them following the manual. Then we've got our wheel pins in here. Now these plastic pins are small. They've already been weakened by model cement or super glue, whatever you'd use to hold those in. So be very, very careful when you twist your wheels on at the end, your wheel backs, you're gonna wanna test fit. And if it doesn't fit easily, drill out your wheel backs with the same kind of pin vise, hand drill or whatever drill you wanna use and open that up. Because if you break these off, then you've got to drill them out. They do give you an extra pair, but you still got to drill it out, try to reinstall the pins, or try to glue the wheel directly to the axle there, and it's just a headache. So try to be careful with those. We've got our loop for our drive shaft on there, and on this one I attached the radiator and the radiator surround because of the way that I'm going to be building my model. It's just the way that I'm going to be doing it. On the drag hood, I drilled out the holes for the clear hood scoop. I love that. I could use the optional hood scoop as well, but that clear one's gonna look really cool on this car the way it does on the box top, so I left it. On the interior, glued the firewall on, did the roll cage, and then we can just unattach that at any time we want. Detach it, unattach it. Now it may seem a little weird because it does lean backwards in those holes, but those are the holes they tell you to open up. We can look at the manual, and you can configure your roll cage any way you want on your model, but on the build here, on the instructions, it says open up the holes on the package shelf. If you're going to be doing the roll cage, open up these holes and open up the ones in the very front. So by doing that, that's what you end up with for that roll cage. And we have our firewall on there, and it looks fine. A little tilted back, probably to fit inside the body or whatnot, and that'll work just fine. It's braced, so it would hold in a crash, not a problem. The rest of the stuff on here, the track bars, the differential, all that stuff will get painted, same as the interior. I'm going to use the stock seats. I like them. I like the seat belts on them. That's what I'm going to use in my build. We've got our interior tub with the rear seat, the side doors. I don't know if I'm going to still use the rear seat or if I'm going to leave it out. I'm not really sure, so I'm not confident on that. The body needed no work. All I did was scrub the body and everything with Simple Green to get it cleaned off. And then our lovely little trailer here. The tailgate opens and closes at will with a good amount of friction, so I didn't need to glue that in place. Looks awesome. We'll get that all painted up like the U-Haul trailers of old days. I think these were U-Haul trailers in the original iterations of these kits. And of course, because of licensing, you know, they have to call it Haul It or U-Haul, you know, whatever. We know what it is, and that's fine. We don't have to pay licensing, so we're not worried about it. We're not going to panic. Looks awesome, and it's an excellent accessory. I'm not putting a trailer hitch on my drag car, though back in the day, someone could have taken a streetable car to the drag strip, towed a trailer there with their fuel and parts in it, with their race wheels or anything, and done it that way. I mean, it's been done. So in your world, you do what you want with your model. I am going to get everything primed and start throwing color at it in just a moment. As usual, it's time to look at things before I button everything up so you can get a little bit of closer view of the model and its assemblies now that we're pushing things together. There are four pins in the bottom of the chassis that attach to the four pins in the bottom of the interior tub. Now on mine, I went with more of a slightly modified but still street looking race car. So you really couldn't drive this down the street in my world that I'm doing this on, but it looks like a street car. I went around and did all the chrome trim. You know, normally on a full race car, you wouldn't have any of that on there. You'd pull that all off to save any bit of weight you could all the way around the doors and everything except the stuff that holds the glass in. But the Coronet body just looks so nice with it on there, and there's such a nice molding that I did leave it alone. I hand painted the back end of the car, got that nice thin strip done. I'd still like to see that on the decal sheet. It wasn't done on the convertible, it's not done on this one. Then I glued the red taillights in. Once I'm all done, I will then do all the silver trim around the edges with one of my gel pens. It'll be easier to hold it that way, and I'll be able to clear coat it and everything, and it will go on much easier when I do all that work back there. On the chassis, we've got that 440 with headers installed, and you definitely needed to remove those torsion bars to get the headers in. Now, there's just no way. I put the traction bars on it, differentials in, drive shaft loop. We've got our wheel and tire package glued on, and even though I warned you, the viewer, not to do it, I snapped a wheel pin off. Luckily, the wheel pin snapped off so that it was still inside the wheel back and it was sticking out. So I just drilled through the hub there and glued it in place. Wasn't too hard. You can see the studs that the interior mounts onto. There's one there. There's one hiding right there. The rear wheels fit onto the metal axle without issue, and it looks pretty cool. The interior looks awesome. I left the rear seat out with the big holes in it that would go right back to the trunk, and that's why I spritzed a little metallic back there. Got our center console, got the dashboard. The dashboard comes to life with a little hand painting and detailing, and I used the light color decals for the gauges so they stand out even more. I wrapped the steering wheel instead of the wood grain for an RT. I did it with black as if he put some foam or grip on the steering wheel. And I left both seats in there so he can run a friend down the track with them whenever they're welcome. Painted in the seat belts by hand, did our door panels and used those lovely Coronet RT decals on the door panels. The engine, you saw me put that all together, glued the battery in place, glued the reservoir tank, got our radiator, and I did everything in a metallic under the hood as if it had been ripped off the car, reinstalled, stripped down to metal, and left that way. That's how I did it up on mine. Got the velocity stacks on there, got the intake painted a different color, and we are ready to go and snap that into the body. Once it's the body's on, we will locate the bumpers. Now, technically, these would be a yellow bulb or an orange bulb inside a clear thing, but I like to do them orange, and a lot of people updated that on theirs, and I just like the look of it. Got our rear bumper, the mirrors if you choose to install them. Somebody that drags but left the chrome trim on might leave the mirrors on too. You never know. The trailer is delightful. I didn't use any decals on this version. On the last version, I used the Haulet decals. This one I left like a plain trailer. Been bought at surplus or been bought on their own. I took the stock wheels because I used the custom wheels on the chassis. And another detail on the custom wheels you probably won't notice from this angle, but I painted the wheelbacks blue on the inside. So we've got the black spokes and then blue on the inside, like the drums are blue, like they painted them blue to match the car. So I took the stock wheels, painted them all black, and took a Q-tip, rubbed the black just off the hub and off the edge of the rim. So a little bit of a tire wheel, a little bit of a trailer wheel upgrade, but nothing too fancy, something you definitely see on something on the road. Got all the tools glued inside, got our jack, fuel tank, toolbox, two jack stands, and the wrench. Glued that all in there. And they look wonderful. It's a great looking trailer, comes out awesome. And finally, the body, like I said, I did that cool hood because I've never seen that before. And if it was on the last version, I just didn't pay attention or looked at it much. Did all the trim. Glass went in beautifully, as you saw. The glass pretty much friction fits, but I still glue it in just to make sure. Got that grill in, just needs a decal. And she is a tough looking ride in that custom blue that I use, that Tamiya Pure Blue. So I'm gonna finish up assembling it all together. I'm gonna decide on which decals, pretty much gonna go box art with most of the decals, except I'm not gonna throw a bunch of sponsor stickers on it. I'm pretty much just gonna go with the Dodge and the Connell's Performance. Get that stripe around the trunk. And when I come back with that, we'll have a final. Hello, awesome model people. We are done with the retooled 1968 Coronet RT, one of the Dodge Scat Pack, right off the top of the box with the vintage box, the oversized box. It's got the Haul-It trailer. It's got the 68 Coronet that you can build one of multiple ways. I went with the drag strip version of the car. I did a assembly similar to the box art. I changed some things to suit myself like I always do. I used the white stripe in the back of mine instead of the red. I thought that stood out nicer with the beautiful Dodge RT logos, which are white and silhouetted in white. I thought those looked nice on my ride. Went with the clear hood like the box art. I went with a black roll bar. They did red on theirs. I went with a blue interior and a blue dash. They went with blue seats and a black dashboard. So I did some similarities and I did stuff on my own. Loved the build, super easy. It's modern engineering of an old kit. So the trailer and the car go together without an issue. And in fact, everything went together so nice and I was such a good mood. There's not a drop of floor polish on this car. Nothing. I laid the decals down and once those dried, we're here on the turntable. That's how nicely the paint laid down. Didn't have to clear coat it. It is super shiny right out of the can this time. Got lucky. Sometimes you just get that super lucky with something. You don't have to do another clear coat or anything like that. So the Tamiya paint on this one just sprayed perfectly and makes me extra, extra happy. So everything goes together fine. Love the look of those wheel and tire set on the drag version. The chassis is a nice tight fit. Line up the rear and then the front will snap into place. The rear is held in with two large pins. The interior snaps into the chassis. I did put the mirrors on mine just because on this one, they're small, they're detailed, they fit nicely, and they just glue on in place, or you can use the studs on them if you want to drill a hole and mount them that way. The roll cage looks nice and it does fit under the roof. It doesn't sit too high. Looks awesome there. And that interior is greatly detailed for being in this scale. The 440 is a good looking engine. It would look good stock. It looks sweet with those injector stacks on there, and we can see everything through that clear hood. So I never knew any of that stuff existed. I think that's pretty awesome. On the decal sheet, you can see what I used and didn't use. What was missing from the decal sheet, again, that I think should be in these Coronet kits is for certain a decal for doing the back. Because when you do the back of the car, you have to not only paint that skinny area, and it's inset, so it's rough to get in there, so I freehand it and clean it up. But then you have to do all the little trim work and the Dodge logo at the bottom. So I had to do all of that with a gel pen, and it would be really cool if they included a silver Dodge script for the lower Dodge logo, and then just a black decal to lay across the back with the silver printed in on the up and down stripes and everything, to just lay over it, rub some decal solvent, it would go right down and make the job a billion times easier. And it would probably look better for a lot of people that don't have super steady hands or don't want to mask that off and airbrush that and spend all that time. So I'll just recommend that again. It's not a downfall of the kit. I would just love to see that included, and especially the silver Dodge logo across the top of the rear there. The bumpers fit in nicely. On the front bumper, like with the convertible, I did have to open the holes that it mounts into. It wouldn't just press fit in. Once I opened those up with a small drill bit, it press fit in. On the rear bumper press fit in nicely, and I held it in place with two drops of super glue. There's no glue holding the body onto the chassis. Absolutely none was needed. With those two large pins underneath the trunk, you snap those in place. When you snap those in place, the wheels automatically line up if you install them correctly, and there really is no way you could not install them correctly because there's large locating pins and a steel axle, and the springs and the differential are all one piece with four holes. There's no way you could put that in wrong. The car sits perfectly, looks like it's about to hit in the drag version. If I ever did one of these again, in the back, I would set the differential up on some blocks or just not push it into the holes, and it would sit a little higher for me and look more like a dragster the way I'd want it to look. The decals laid down, that nice bumblebee stripe looks awesome. Those Dodge RT logos are going to be popular in other kits. I think these Dodge Fever ones will also be pretty popular. People might buy the kit just for those decals, especially those. Those will look good on any Mopar from any era. Really sharp looking. And now you have a bunch of back end stripes. You have police department logos, fire chief logos, haul it logos. You have all kinds of stuff on here. Mopar stuff, 440s, 375 horsepower, some sweet MPC decals, all kinds of stuff. Even the really cool bumper stickers right there. You can see them just chilling on the decal sheet. I don't know if the camera will focus that close, but yeah. Classic Mopar decals on there. You could use as bumper stickers on any other kit. Lots of cool stuff in this giant box. Two complete kits that you can build any way you want. I want to thank Round 2 for sending this over. I will link in the description as soon as I have pre-order information available. And we will see all of you at the next review.